First off, before we get into the video, I want to promote this website that is about free advertising for bikes and parts and other associated things in the motorcycle world. It was created by my friend in Texas, Mike Jones, and this is a video about his attempt at the land speed record with a turbocharged 100cc. And so yeah, you can advertise. You're looking for parts, you're buying parts, you're looking for a motorcycle, you're selling a motorcycle, even motorized bicycles. It's a great website. It's a great resource. When you place an ad, you'll have this section right here, and if you select Michael Forrest channel, that's my channel, this one right here, if you select that, his motorcycle classifieds will donate $1 to me, which is going to be helpful and helps me pay for the expenses I'm incurring and doing this research on motorcycle oils. So go there and check it out. I don't know about you, but I'm still excited about this new topic of combination tuning. Looking at it, not just one thing at a time, but looking at it all together. How do they all work together to get that peak pressure in the cylinder right at that moment between 10 degrees and 15 degrees after top dead center? Maybe having it spread out. Maybe it have it all squished together. Talking about the pressure graph, it depends upon what the engine wants. And you'll know what the engine wants by your times when you do the testing between the two markers on the road, your acceleration test. You could do top speed tests, but it's not as good. You're always going through the RPM range when you're riding. You're not just at the very, very top of it. So, yeah, I think this is fantastic. Like a neat way to synthesize all this information together, see how it works together, and to utilize it together to get that final, whatever it is, 2 or 3% of power out of the engine. So, like I said before, you're normally not going to mess with the compression. Okay, you might mess with the squish. This is my squish calculator. And I just modified it to analyze according to the compression ratio, the top RPM, and the squish velocity, whether it recommends to you a fast burn oil or a slow burn oil, which is this right here. And this is the note on the subject. Let's see if I can get that up a little bit. This is the note on the subject. If you want to pause and read that. So, yeah, well, you got to know what your squish is doing. Most stock squish velocities are too slow and the volume is too large, and they do that because of manufacturing tolerances and because going in that direction ensures a little bit more reliability. Okay, so that is something that can almost always be improved on, is the squish velocity and the squish volume. I highly recommend my calculator. If the squish volume and velocity is not what is recommended, then I highly recommend you take that head to a machine shop and have them change it according to what you figured out on the calculator that you can do. And even though I don't charge very much for the calculators, I'm always here to help you if you have any questions. I want to see you have success. That's just as important to me as making money from these calculators. So you get your compression, your squish set. Then does the program still recommend a certain type of oil? Okay. And the ratio, you can do different tests with the ratio. On my engine, because it's a street bike and it does not have a squish band, it wants a shorter burn because its burn time is too long now without the squish velocity speeding things up. So when I tested the Castor 927, it turned out to be a slow burn oil because of the effect of the synthetic oil in it, and I got more power by using less oil. So that's a good example of engine oil and ratio. I used the wrong type of oil. My engine does not want synthetic. It wants Castor. So if I had had Castor in there, a lower ratio would have given a better result than a higher ratio, meaning it would have liked more of the oil instead of less of it. You put the wrong oil in there, it'll want less of it. You put the right oil in there, it'll want more of it. So step one, step two, and then there's the jetting and the tuning. And that is something that you you test three main jets on the standard tuning, and then you change that tuning 3 degrees, and you retest those three. And then you go 3 degrees in the other direction, and you test them again, and then you look and see what you've got. And it can be a little bit complex there too. So if you have any questions, I'm here to help you. This picture is a good illustration of how close competitors can be in a race and how every little amount of power that the engine can give is important. You might say, well, I'm not racing. Well, I'm not either, but I'm riding a 48cc. And sometimes my life depends upon passing that stupid taxi. Because if I'm side by side with that taxi and here comes the giant transportation truck, my life is at risk. So I want all the power I can get. Thank you. This center section is the nine main tests. I want to point out something here to you. In this case, this run and this run with this main jet and, well, all three of these main jets with the current timing, when it does that, that's a pattern that shows you that the timing is too advanced. So that right there will tell you you got to go more retarded. So your next test would be down here, not up here, down here in the retarded section. And by retarded on most bikes, if you rotate the stator plate counterclockwise, that makes it more retarded. And if you don't know how much to move it and there's no markings there on the plate, just measure the radius or the diameter of that plate and give it to me, and I'll figure out how much you need to move it. So in this case, you would go do these three tests. And then there's some other patterns too that I'm realizing that exist. And let's say all three of these are going better or worse in time. These are the acceleration times. You don't have a clear winner, a clear peak. So if the times are going up towards the right, that means you want to be more to the left. You want lower times, so you would include this column for testing. If it does the opposite, then you would include this column for testing. But like I said, there's a lot of different variables here. So if you want to do this testing and you need some help, some guidance, make this chart here, build it in as best as you can, and then share it with me, and I'll give you my comments on it. So my next series of tests will be with a synthetic blend with mineral oil, group 2 mineral oil, the Kawasaki oil, and one of the fully castor oils. And concerning castor oil, it has come to my attention that if you use enough of it, it coats the piston well enough that it keeps it from burning a lot of oil onto the top of it. So that's a good way to get around the bad aspect of it that a lot of people have wanted to avoid, and which is why they don't use castor oil. So stay tuned, and I'll hopefully have more information to you on this subject very soon. Thank you for watching, and take care.